Happy Thumbs Gaming. Big show.
Hey everybody, it's Brian with Happy Thumbs Gaming. Today we're checking out Free Roam, Bywater and Barrow-downs, Quest and Collectibles. Probably sure I'm saying that wrong, but anyways, there are a couple of red bricks in this area, and we do pick up 12 Mithrils, as well as Tilda, Bane, Bofur, Lake Town Edition, Tom Troll, Barrow White, and Tom Bombadil. I'm sure I'm saying all those names wrong too, but you know what? I apologize, and that's all I can really do. So here we are. I will kick off by saying that we are going to try to do these in the order of the towns, but we have found out that sometimes one mission being completed will actually open up another, and they're not always in the same area, so there may be some traveling back and forth at some points, and we do a little traveling, in between some towns and like forging debris and stuff, but we edited most, if not all, of that stuff out. So right off the bat, we use the statue stone to go ahead and teleport there, and we follow the little stud trail back to one of the first Mithril bricks. This one takes us to a door that opens up and actually provides us with a nice little area here, which actually happens to be a little sanctuary designated for Mr. Gandalf. This lovely young woman here, who looks a lot like Rosie Cotton, happens to tell us that Gandalf is one of her most sought-after wizards, and she absolutely loves him, and if she could, she would stare at him all day. Stock much, Rosie? I don't know, but she does let us know that all in all, really she just wants us to provide her with some sort of a statue. And you know what? We can do that. So it will go ahead and provide us with a Lego anvil loot builder here, and we can go ahead and build those up. Now, if you guys are short on loot for any of these, there is a dwarven loot dispenser that actually is right behind where you spawn each time you complete a level or you enter the game or turn it on. So it's an Erebor. There's a crack behind it. We actually have a video for it, so check that out. Speaking of which, as we build up this Gandalf the Great at times 5 speeds there, I want to mention that we do have timeline quick links to all of our collectibles down below. So if you're only looking for the red bricks in this area, or maybe you have the Mithril bricks, but whatever the case may be, go ahead and use those links to go ahead and skip through. And it'll sure save you a lot of time, because some of these Mithril bricks take a minute or two to go ahead and complete. And who's got all that extra time? In the infamous words of the internet, ain't nobody got time for that. All right, so we went ahead and we smashed and grabbed everything in that little area, but we removed that so you wouldn't have to watch it. And here we are right outside the cave. So we'll go ahead and move right down along and follow the yellow brick road. This takes us to a blue door that opens up kind of suspectly and invites us in. So, hey, what's cracking inside here? This dude actually tells us that he is having a hard time building some pies. That's my pie pack, kitty. No. He actually needs bread, though, so it looks like he's maybe making some bread pudding or something instead of pie. Never seen bread get used to make pie. I know there's kind of a crust, but that's not bread now. Come on. All right, again, this is going to require some Lego loot. There is a handful of bread rolls in this room if you smash some of that stuff, and if you, who knows. But more than likely, you have enough. You need 50 for this, so dump 50 in there. If you need to go travel to Erebor and use the Lego loot dispenser, go ahead and do it. Otherwise, go ahead and drop the bread like it's hot, because it might be fresh out the oven, and we'll move along once we get our Mithril. It's funny, I was instructed big time that the Mithril bricks were called Mithril, but if you listen to the characters in the story of this game, they actually all call them the Mithril. So if I am saying it wrong, my bad, but it's all at discretion of our viewers, so it's your own fault. No, I'm just kidding. All right. Now that we have completed that mission, it actually opened up 2 red bricks. So if you're red brick hunting and that's all you're after, we'll probably get a red brick video out there and try to explain all those. But like I said in the beginning of this video, some of these missions are dependent on completing other ones. So until you get the 50 bread for Buddy, he's not going to offer this character studs red brick, which does cost you a little bit of cheese. And this is one of those moments where we did leave and come back with the appropriate item. As you can see there, we didn't have it, and now we do's. So we paid him off, and bleakashow. So that's one thing that I still don't understand. If you're listening, TT Games, how are you going to make me do something and reward me with a brick that costs me more money? That's like saying, hey, you just won the lottery. You can collect all this money, but you have to pay for it first. It's like, what? Say what? All right, and one right after another. This dude is outside now, and he's telling us that his mother-in-law is a pain in the butt, so he needs this new item called the Mithril Catchphrase. And, you know, honestly, I haven't used it yet. I even went and forged it for him. As you can see, I just edited there, went to Bree, forged it. Since we have all the schematics, we just needed certain Mithril bricks, and I didn't have enough to forge them all. So make sure that you don't go and forge the wrong ones. Otherwise, you'll be on the search for some Mithril bricks. But once you provide him with the Catchphrase Mallet, it actually gives us the opportunity to buy the Always Loot Sapphires. Now, this is kind of a bogus one, too, because it costs you $600,000. And what it does is when you smash and loot something, like you break a barrel or something like that, it ends up kicking out sapphires instead of wood or rope or fish or whatever the case may be. Now, that's great, but so far in my game, I haven't ran into any excessive need for sapphires, so nor can I go and sell them anywhere that I'm aware of. So if you guys know something I don't, drop a comment down below. It'd be greatly appreciated. Otherwise, now that we've helped Buddy out with his dreadful mother-in-law, we'll go ahead and move along. We're going to give you a quick example, though. As you can see here, instead of wood or leather or any kind of the normal items that would destroy and drop there, it actually gives us the sapphires, which, hey, there's one of the most expensive Lego loots that you can purchase, but come on, can't sell them, so it doesn't do us any good. All right, so right across in this little island here, right outside the door of where we just were, destroy all the debris and then use Saruman's war. What? What am I saying here? You know what I'm saying. Use Saruman or the fireworks bow. Boom. Done deal. Moving on now. All right. Tilda is right around the corner in town. I love how these areas. So this is why people ask, why do you do it by area rather than by item? It would be so much easier if you just went from area to area getting all the items one by one. Well, you know, that does make sense, and it is easier to track video-wise, but realistically, when you're here, wouldn't you rather do all of these things at once and be prepared for all of these things? So, as we get lost and can't find Tilda's house, we pull out our GPS, and it takes us right back to where we need to go, and we'll slip on inside. Before destroying her house, make sure you purchase her up, because you'd hate for her to raise her price after you trash her house. No, I'm just kidding. That doesn't happen. You can trash the whole house, and she'll still be 15K. But Tilda is now on our list, and our character list is actually building up pretty nicely. In fact, by the end of this video, it looks even sweeter. So here's Bane. I don't know if this is the same Bane from Batman or not, or the DC world, I guess. But So, hey, I want to give a shout-out, I believe, and I could be wrong here, to Jeff. Now, Jeff, if you are, in fact, the one that told me, then props to you, and you know who you are. But I was kind of unaware about the stud, the mount situation. I was unaware that you could pull out that guy. Like, I saw it in the menu, but I wasn't exactly sure what it was, and I surely didn't think I had access to it yet, especially since they're all custom, and it looks like you don't have any of those characters. So, look, it definitely speeds things up, and I'm greatly appreciative. And if I had your whole name, I'd probably give you a shout-out, but I believe it was Jeff. I want to say, like, Hancock's not it, but it's something close to that. Giggity. All right, so Bane is next on the list, 15K. He's unlocked, and as you can see, you needed the human tether ball to pull that hook and then cross the bridge and Booyaka Shao. So you should have completed the story and free play by now, so you should have no problem with pulling out that character, and it should just be a matter of going to there and making it happen. So back across the bridge. Ooh, we can see there is some shenanigans going on out there on that up that top. I don't know what that means, but it's up there. And okay, we can see we got some brush we need to destroy, and there's a target, it looks like. So first things first, let's pull out somebody who can shoot some bows and arrows at peoples. Yeah, I know you don't shoot bows. I know somebody was already thinking in their head, what is this guy? You don't shoot. Yeah, I know. I say lots of things that don't make sense, and that's why you love me, because I don't make sense. No, I'm just kidding. I do make sense. My videos make sense, but I may not. All right, this is pretty easy. Once you destroy the brush, just hit the target and Booyaka Shao. Spend 25 grand and get a new buddy. Think if in life it were this easy. If you just had all this money and you could just roll around buying friends. Some of you might actually do that. That's the irony of that. All right, so moving along to the next one. We got another Mithril brick coming up here. We got a couple characters last few, so let's go ahead and do something productive, huh? Oh, what is this? They're all at night. So this was a big question in LEGO Lord of the Rings. They did actually make this a little bit easier to understand in LEGO The Hobbit. But essentially, instead of going to the Travel Stone like before, you're going to find these little campsites and just walk up to them and activate them by pressing the icon indicated and then pull out your wieners and let the fun begin, right? Not sure whose idea that was. Marshmallows probably would have been a better idea, despite the fact that they probably didn't have marshmallows back then. And but that would have made it that much more funny. You know what I'm saying? Like, if dude pulled out a Hershey bar and made some s'mores, wouldn't that be funnier than a wiener every time? I mean, I'm just saying. All right, so we've made it night, and we got to roll out. So we're going to hop on our steed here, our noble steed, and make our way to the next icon, which happens to be the Farmyard Fiasco, which I already promised is a Mithril Brick. So essentially what's happening here is there's a bunch of dudes coming to ruin the party here. So it's up to you to go ahead and crash it. And not the whole Vince Vaughn Wedding Crasher style, because in the end, that's a happy ending, and he gets all soft. This would not work. That would not work here. You have to take out these evil, they look like Morgul wargs, but they're not quite, they don't have that effervescence of negativity or evil floating off of them. They don't have that, the stank, so to speak. So I don't know if they're actually Morgul or what. I'm sure he'd probably told us, but you know what? It's sped up, and I've got the volume turned down for this recording, so you guys don't have to hear it echoing in the background, so... My bad on the actuality there, but you know what? Hey, 15 of them are now dead. Dude is now happy, and oh to the yeah, we can now move on. So I like how he makes note of the trolls, too, because I didn't think there'd be any trolls nearby, but eventually here we actually pick up a troll by the end of this video. So, and if you're in a hurry to check that out, go ahead and look down below in the video quick links and use them to skip ahead. And it's about the 22-minute mark, maybe 23-minute mark, something like that. So... All right, I try to keep it fresh, and I pull out a new steed almost every time, a new Mountie. I guess a Mountie is a Canadian officer, so maybe that's not the proper word there. My bad, Canadian folk. Maybe I'll be like Shaq and fail the Canadian test like the other night on TNT and NBA and TNT. That was pretty funny. If you guys haven't seen that, Google that. Yeah, Charles Barkley. I guess it was Charles, not Shaq. Did I say Shaq? I don't know. Charles Barkley fails the Canadian test big time on NBA on TNT. So it's on Google, YouTube, whatever. I've seen it. It's funny. All right, so this got a little confusing for me, too. You're supposed to follow this guy, which is not confusing at all. But unfortunately, the icon that you indicate for this mission doesn't move with him. Like, that's one thing that I'd like to see. It's very minor and probably not very hard to accomplish. But the little arrow guiding you to this mission should probably be updated and follow the cart. Just in case you get sidetracked, like let's say you go to mine some rocks or something and you come back and buddy's gone, you don't know. That would be really helpful because otherwise you're going to run back to the beginning of the level and that's not going to do you any good. But essentially, I believe there's three stops along the way on this one. And all we're going to do here is just take out all the baddies that pop out from the ground. Once they're all done and you kill them, he will actually continue to move along. Be careful though, he will run you over without thinking twice. And although it doesn't hurt you, it does flatten you. Makes you a little pavement patty. In fact, I experienced that a couple more times. And I try to sneak in a little mining game here while we're waiting. Get a few pieces of loot and some studs. And I was trying to get the perfect. Because at this point in the video, I had or in this my gameplay, I had not gotten the trophy achievement yet for getting 50 perfect mining games. But as of right now, as of me talking, I most certainly have done that. And I am definitely further than what you're seeing right now as far as my gameplay goes. And who knows, you may be watching this in 6 months or a year from now, and I may have the entire series done and done three Lego games since. But, ooh, look at that, pavement patty. All right, so we're just going to keep on following him. He goes right into town. As soon as he makes it to town, he gives us a little celebratory woohoo, or she does, rather. And then eventually she gives us some more quests. So that's awfully nice of her. We'll come back to that in a little bit. All right, another Mithril Brick, which, you know, I know it's probably a little confusing that I've got them labeled number 5 and number 6 when really my count in-game is very different. But as I mentioned in a previous video, I'll go ahead and mention it real quick now as we move on to the next Mithril Brick, which is really one of the easier ones right outside of Bree here. Still in Bywater, though. At least, I believe it is. I could be wrong on that. But it's right there. It's on the cusp of Bywater and Bree. And, all right, so what I was saying is yeah, basically, yeah, that's what I was saying. You missed it, go back. No, I'm just kidding, I didn't say anything. I don't remember what I was saying, so it wasn't important. Basically, yeah, tight pants, tight rope it all the way to the top. That's where I was going. I should go back and listen, because I know I had an important point. My bad, guys. But once you get all the way to the top of the rope, I was going to show you the map one more time, but it wouldn't let me, so yeah. All right, so we're moving along. And, oh, to the, yeah. All right, so here we go. Let's see if we can get that. Boika shao. All right, terrible mining. I surely would not be a terrific miner in these ages. I think I'd be, I don't know. I'd probably be a better couch potato. That's probably my best roll of this time. All right, we're marking the next one here. This one might be a little bit tricky because it's depending on which angle you're coming from. You might not find this door on the backside of this rock. You might find yourself up on top of the rock looking around or whatever. But essentially inside, we are going to find ourselves a young lady. She might be of familiar looking to you. And if not, if she's not familiar, we'll still help her out anyways because we're not like that. We're not judging a book by its cover here. Despite her lime green shirt that matches our hairdo, you know, I guess maybe that's what we'll, because she matched our hairdo, we'll go ahead and help her out. That's how we'll roll with it. All right, rather than cut these out, I did speed these up dramatically, so it looks like I'm really good at building. It's like a 5 or 6 times speed-wise there, so just really wanted to show what we're building and complete the fact that, hey, she needed a well. This mission's called Well, 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 and well, she got what she wanted. Ba-dum-bum-tsh. All right, so another Mithril Brick added to our pile. It does get pretty close in the next area. I get really close. Like, I almost can't. In fact, there's one point where I can't complete one of the required red brick items for the quest without going and getting a few other Mithril Bricks out and scattered. So, anyways, we're going to switch back to Mr. Legolas, and once you come out of that tunnel, you can actually return right back in there, and as promised, Tom the Troll is going to be available for you, so it's one of those things where you have to build the well first, so if you go in there and you're looking for the troll, you have to build the well. Make sure you do that, and well, you'll figure it out if you don't. Ba-dum-bum-tsh. You know, I haven't had any owl jokes, so I figured I'd roll with some well jokes. It worked out pretty well, too, don't you think? All right, I'm done. We've all had enough of that. All right, so we've targeted the next brick, which happens to be up and around the way. And we'll hop on our faithful red steed here and make our way. It's actually a warg, I believe, this time. Yep, little kitty cat. And this one was almost confusing, but it really wasn't confusing. I had a little bit of a program glitch. So you'll see it here, and I'll explain it just so in the event it happens to you, you know what to do. Basically, he tells this big long story and says, come on, let's go check it out. Well, for some reason, he doesn't go with me. You can see he's like standing there not doing anything. So I ended up running around, checking some stuff. I went into a tunnel, came back. He was still standing there. I talked to him again, and this time he just ran off like you just saw. Like, there was no hesitation. There was no me doing anything that changed it. He just runs off. So, and he's pretty fast too, I gotta say. He does take us on a nice little journey right around the front side of Bree. And over into Barrow-downs. Not Barrow-right, as I originally called it and had to go back and edit. So you guys don't know that because I've changed it. At least I hope I did. If I didn't, that's terrible. But at the beginning, I had it. I mislabeled it. And when I did the audio, I misread it. And so I'm going to have to go back and do that. Or I should have had to go back and do that. All right. So a nice little homage to the golf game here. They're saying that basically a goblin's head rolls down, and I think it's a goblin's head, ends up in a hole, and that's how they invented golf. Basically, you take dude here, show him the golf course, which is a very small little putt-putt par 3 course, and at that point, you go ahead and you get rewarded with that brick. So now, moving along in Barrow-downs, you can see that there is not a lot going on up above where we started in Bywater, so we're going to go ahead and try to finish up down low. We do see that there is a new quest up there in Bywater, though. So again, one of those quests that popped up after completing another one. And unfortunately, I'd like to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and get them all done all at once, but sometimes it doesn't work out that way. Sometimes you have to go A, B, C, then come back and do 5, 6, 7. So if that didn't make sense to you, don't worry about it. I'm just saying that it doesn't always work out in the proper order for this video, but there is a methodical order that the game is in, and we're going to try to follow that as much as possible. So, oh to the yeah, here we are again trying to sneak in a perfect mine. I actually get one there, but it wasn't good enough. I didn't quite hit that 50 for that trophy achievement yet. We'll get there, I promise. But this one, we haven't seen this in a while. Old Radagast the Brown can use his Pepto-Bismol to go ahead and kill that tummy cramp here for the old possum. And this time, he didn't poop out any studs. He pooped out a Mithril Brick. So that's mighty nice of him, although hopefully we brought some sort of sanitizing creams to go ahead and clean that up because that surely isn't healthy. And this one was a little bit of a pain for me. I won't say pain, I should say. I thought it might have been in there. Clearly, it's not. Then I think I see these little jumps. And I'm like, oh, you got to jump across these rocks. Well, truth be told, you can pretty much run up the side of the hill there. In fact, you go back a little bit towards Bree, and you can see that nice angle there that you can run right up. But I also proved to you that you can run right up the side right here. So don't waste too much time trying to make those jumps, if you were. And right around the corner up top is Mr. Barrow Wright, which is the whole reason I labeled this video incorrectly and had to go back and edit it. So, oh, yeah. Barrowite. He's a Barrowite, like a Tolkienite. See, I've been calling you guys Tolkienites out there for a while, you Tolkien fans, and here I didn't even know they were going to make fun of me by calling it a Barrowite. Because we're in Barrow-downs, it's a local person, a Barrowite, you know? I don't know. You probably know what that means. You get it. I shouldn't have to explain that any further, I don't think. All right, so this was another one of those moments where, you know, there's more than one way to get to the top of the hill. I don't necessarily choose the easiest way, but with an elf, you can actually get your hop on. So you could destroy that little mine brick there and you know, maybe even get the mining perfectly 50 times trophy achievement. But if not, make your way to the very back. And there's a couple of little tasks that we need to do in order to get up to the very top where this mithril brick is located. And what we're going to do here is we're going to start by going to the dwarf pole. So pull out your dwarf of choice with a pole. And go ahead and stand on his head and climb up top and flip that switch. Now over right on the other side of this apparatus, we're going to find ourselves a little picnic blanket. So we can go ahead and toss Fatty on it and then stuff his gordo again. Or stuff his gourd. Gordo. Gordo burrito. Gordo blanquito. I don't know. Whatever. And so, yeah, we're going to go ahead and jump to the top and flip that switch. Once we flip that switch, it gives us the access we need to get all the way up and across, as long as we can navigate across that pane and not fall off like the super noob we are. And, yeah, we got Mithril Brick number 10. All right, only a couple more items here. One, the next one being Tom Bambiddle. I'm not sure I'm saying that right, but this dude, I believe, is a strong character. At least he was in Lord of the Rings. I did not know that until after I was done playing. One of our awesome viewers, like yourself, went out of their way to tell me that. And although most of the time when I'm done with a series and a fact like that is given to me, it's not very helpful. In this particular case, it was, because they brought it back around, and I'm pretty sure he's a strong character. And hey, you could correct me or agree with me down below in the comments and let me know to verify. You guys are pretty good at that. Now, this confused me for a half a second, but I figured it out, and I got super lucky because it only took me one attempt at this. But get your boing on and go right into that little halo of ghostliness. And once you do, it starts a timer. And you got to be kind of precise here. And like I said, I got lucky. I didn't really know what I was doing, and I just went for it. And look at that. Booyakashow. First try, and I got it. Now they give you a little bit of a payout on the way back here. Just some golds. Nothing too spectacular. And I don't think if you bounce long enough they give you any more. They might, but definitely worth jumping up and getting those golds, especially if you got a multiplier on. Even a times two gives you, you know, an extra handful. And that'll surely help when purchasing Mr. Tom Bombadil for a large 30K. Actually, 30K is nothing. You can get that pretty quickly, with or without multiplier. So, and here we go. One of the last mithril bricks right here. We're going to go ahead and jump on. And this one actually told us to go around and down and over and through the woods and trying to go to my grandmother's house, too. We weren't down with that. We actually took a shortcut. If you look, you can kind of walk right back over and drop right down. I tried to hit that little swing there, but it didn't work out. But you can see there's multiple ways to get up and down over here, and it sure saved us some time from pulling out our steed and running all the way around and back here. And once you get here, you can actually pull out Tom the Troll, since you have him now, or use the old stone gloves on any of the characters. And those stone gloves were found as a treasure in one of the free play videos. So if you haven't completed free play and you don't have those yet, at least we showed you where Tom the Troll is. And if you haven't completed free play, shame on you. Go do that right now. Seriously. I don't want you to. No. Pause it right now. No, I'm going to stop it. No mithril brick for you. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to play it anyways, and if you just click the link and you're wondering what's going on, we'll go ahead and start with the caw-caw, caw-caw, because we're flying, and that's what happens when we fly. We gotta speak the eagle-ese. I don't know. I'm trying to make that work. It's not working. But now that we're – keep in mind, it is nighttime too, people. So if this quest isn't showing for you, make sure that the sun is down, and this will actually complete – our quests, at least for now, through Bywater and Barrow Downs. So This one just requires the Morgul blade, which I accidentally happen to have. If you didn't hear already, after getting all the schematics, I actually went and tried to forge them all, but then I realized I was not going to have enough Mithril Brick, so I got a handful of forgings done, and that one just happened to be one of the ones that I did earlier. So the Morgul blade is something you can find the schematic for in free play. Like I said, if you haven't completed free play, go do that now. And I mean complete it, like all the characters, you beat it, you got all the Minikits, all the treasures, and booyakashow. So, and then I would go ahead and I would definitely do the schematics throughout the land. Save yourself a lot of extra time traveling back and forth. You're still going to have to travel back and forth at times, but it'll help out. But on that note, we're going to wrap up Lego The Hobbit Free Roam, Bywater and Barrow-downs Quests and Collectibles. We're going to try to knock all these out one by one, and hopefully they won't take too long. And I will say they do take a little bit longer than the average free play videos or something like that. But you guys have asked for them, so we're going to give them to you. Hey, speaking of asking for, if you guys have any questions or comments, or you just want to, you know, maybe converse with some other happy thumb gamers like yourself, head on over to Facebook, Twitter, comment down below. We do have a G+ page, even though the rumors are G+ is not going to be around much longer. That's right. You're hearing it here not first. You probably heard it elsewhere. But Google it. Look it up. Tell me what you know, because I'm curious. I don't know if that social network's going to survive or not. Lots of negative things being said about it. I never got into it. I don't really use it a whole lot, but we do have one. So we try to use it when you guys converse with us. And, of course, we do have a Twitch account as well. So head on over there. We got lots of people interested in helping us out, writing guides, doing videos even. If that's something you want to do, head on over to our, any of our social pages, really, or even head to the contact form at HappyThumbsGaming.com. Send us a little note about yourself. Tell us how old you are, why you think you would be a beneficiary member of the team, and we'll go from there. So, as always, until next time, I'm going to drag it on for a long time, and then I'm going to say see ya at the end. Well, I'm just explaining because I said, as always, until next time. Normally, I actually just go quiet, but this time, I'm actually explaining what I'm doing. So when I finally get to the Sia at the end, you kind of know what's coming instead of, and I don't know. You probably already quit watching this right now anyways, and it's getting pretty boring, so I'll go ahead and end it with a